Not here. I told you to meet me in Riverwood.
You still need to remove that bloodstain.
I'll see you back in Riverwood.
I like how she hangs out here.
Of course, Mom.
When you're supposed to meet her in Riverwood. I was looking for merchants. I need to sell stuff.
Kodlak Whitemane has been laid to rest, I know. I assume you saw the Gildergreen? It's part of the Temple of Kinnereth.
And I also want
to
do the
something about it, but I don't know what they expect.
The Ebony Sword quest.
Been hearing some strange tales of the Jarl's children. Say the ones turning wicked, and the others have an ill-favored look to them. Best to keep clear. Need anything else? Just let me know.
And then I was wondering, is Nettlebane...
Why, good evening.
...a Daedric artifact?
It's been a pleasure.
Huh?
Because now I'm thinking, do I need to do the tree quest and get Nettlebane to count as the 15th, one of the 15 Daedric things I'm supposed to collect? For some reason, the unofficial patch made Ariel's bow a Daedric artifact. Not sure why they would do that. Maybe some players would complain they couldn't get that achievement. You know, wham.
How's it going?
They did a quest wrong, and they didn't get the Daedric artifact from the quest. And they don't want to start the whole game over again just to do an achievement.
Dragons breathing fire in the sky. Vampires bracing the
attack, you know,
people on the street. Come dragon, it's the end of the world, we'll be ready.
Oh, the guards are...
Sure use a warm bed right about now.
Too many guards in this place.
Next time.
Let's find that totem shield, brother.
Oh, let's get some people to dance.
Until next time.
So they're not all just standing around.
If it's
nothing.
A lady you're looking for, you... Sure. What can I do for you? Only true Imperials request that one.
I'm curious who will get picked for the dancing.
We drink to our youth. Today's come and gone.
Oh,
it's
Isolde?
A fine day with you around.
Isolde gets to do the dancing.
Yeah. These Khajiit make a living traveling the roads and selling their wares.
But I'm talking to her instead of her dancing.
It's got to be tough. Skyrim's a hard enough land when you've got a roof over your head. Worst thing is, nobody wants them in the cities. Nobody trusts them. Matter of fact, I do. They've been fair enough with me, far as I can tell. And a Nord knows a liar when she sees
one. I can't remember if I did the stupid... Mammoth Tusk
talking to you.
Quest for her or not. I'm guessing I did. Ages ago. Okay, so they're all doing their thing now. So the guards that were watching me, they left. But there's still guards in here eating. So I can't just be sneaking around. Also, the werewolf lady. What's her name? Aella? She's part of the guard faction, so I can't
Another
really do stuff
here to lick my father's boots.
With her watching me.
So, the disgusting pig sent you to bother me. One day, I'll tear his face apart so he can leave me alone. My father doesn't know anything about me. But I know about him, and about the war. More than he might think. I know that he still worships Talos. That he hates the Thalmor almost as much as the Stormcloaks do. That he worries about being chased from Whiterun. That he... That I'm... that I don't have the same mother as my brother and sister.
I probably mentioned this before.
The castle is old. Lots of places nobody's been in a long while.
But are any of the Jarls married?
Things. See things.
Are any of the Thanes
and
married?
The Whispering Lady. She won't tell me her name. I've gotten good at listening to keyholes. At the door in the basement, I hear her talking to me. I thought I was caught.
Like Jarl Elisif. She was married.
But I can't open the door. In the basement. Trust me, you'll see it. I bet she'll talk to you too.
Ulfric wasn't married. Baldriff wasn't married. The other one wasn't married. The other one wasn't married. The other one wasn't married. And then the replacements that take over as Jarl. I can't think of any of them being married.
At last. I've been waiting for someone more fit to carry out my will.
Relenting force. Da. Which means...
Man, we just... What happened there? I think I ran out of hard drive space.
With all three words together, this shout is much more powerful. Use it. Master Wolfgar will now gift you with his knowledge of Dar. You have completed your training, Dragonborn.
I like how they, when they say my name,
we will
I,
speak to you.
I can actually understand
between
it.
Us and prepare yourself. You can withstand the
undying. And the ground shakes when they say my name.
But you are ready.
I think that happens after this little thing here goes on.
Ingra, Rossis, Saran, Strondul, Bosni Balan.
But for some reason, my companions didn't make it to High Hrothgar. They got stuck on the path near the bottom. What's this mountain called that I'm on? Does it have a name? So I want to say my companions are still in Iverstead, not knowing where the heck I went to. Because I was running really fast.
Pass through unscathed. High Hrothgar is open to you. Wind, guide you.
I wanted him to tell me
he
where a word wall
traditional
was.
Traditional words of greeting to a dragonborn who has accepted our guidance. The same words were used to greet the young Talos when he came to High Hrothgar before he became the Emperor Tiber Septim. Ah, I sometimes forget you are not versed in the dragon tongue as we are. This is a rough translation.
Anyway, this guy looks pretty darn good.
Long has the
for 1K textures.
With no worthy brow to sit upon. By our breath, we bestow it now to you in the name of kind.
That was one of the issues I was worried about when I switched my EMB over to the NLA.
Dragon of the North.
Like, what would my 1K textures look like? The same, or worse, or better?
You have learned so much already, Dragonborn. Growing your gift too quickly would be dangerous. But there are many words of power in Skyrim, carved in the dragon tongue. Even from here, we can feel the thum resonate from them. Finding these lost words would be a sufficient test.
Okay, so he's going to tell me where a word wall is. Good.
Ask when you are ready to search. We have felt the whisper of a word. Give me your map and I will show you where its echo can be found.
I wonder if someone's made a mod for just the Greybeards.
He was a great war leader of the ancient.
To overhaul everyone's face.
The voice or tongue. After the disaster at Red Mountain, where the Nord army was annihilated, he spent many years pondering the meaning of that terrible defeat.
I mean, is there an overhaul for monks in Skyrim?
Blasphemous misuse of the voice. He was the first to understand that the voice,
you know, give them beards that a monk would have instead of a Nord beard.
The glory of men. Jürgen Windcaller.
I don't know if that's a thing in Skyrim.
Eventually overcame all opposition.
Because in Fallout 3, they have monk facial hair that you can use for your character. But I don't think they have monk hair for Skyrim characters.
The voice was a gift of the goddess Kinnereth at the dawn of time. She gave mortals the ability to speak as dragons do.
And you know they can't do this now. They can't make Greybeards now if they wanted to, because it's all guys. It's all white guys.
True mastery of the voice can only be achieved.
You know, women can never be Greybeards.
Is in harmony with your outward actions.
But I'm sure there's a mod out there that's replaced
Kinnereth's domain and the practice of the voice.
Some of the Greybeards with female ones.
That is commendable. But remember, the dragon blood is itself a gift of Akatosh. Do not try to deny that gift. Your destiny requires you to use your voice. Why else would Akatosh have bestowed this power upon you? If you remember to use your voice in service to the purpose of Akatosh, you will remain true to the way.
Man, he has so much backstory to tell you. So much.
Breath and focus.
I am still learning stuff from these guys by clicking on things I haven't looked at in years. And maybe it didn't make sense back then, but now it makes total sense when I hear it a second time. You know, thousands of playthrough hours later. Now that I think about it, can I even wear a Greybeard robe? Is that even a thing? Are there any dead Greybeards in my game? I don't think so. I don't think my playthrough will ever have it. Dead Greybeard where I can just take their clothes. And even if I had their clothes, would I be able to wear it? Or is it only something an NPC can wear? And it's not a player character thing. I was still hoping that my companions would show up, like fast travel here or something, or warp to me, but it doesn't look like that's gonna happen. Once again, I am out of map markers, so I can't even see where my companions are hiding outside down the hill. Quite a ways. I want to blame Red Mountain out there. Anyway, so what I thought I would do is just head back to Whiterun. Since it's pretty much closer than what it really looks like, I thought, what the heck. I won't let the smoke and mirrors interfere with my judgment. I'll just run down there, and I'll be there in like a minute. It's way quicker than running down the path to get there. Red Mountain, I'm not sure why Red Mountain is even there, but it is. I would think that it would be farther east. But I guess I'm disoriented. I don't know what direction I'm actually facing. I can't see on the compass down below if I'm facing west or north or east. I want to say to get from Throat of the World to Whiterun, you have to go northwest. Oh, I see. I'm not heading towards Whiterun. I'm heading towards Fort Amol. Oh, that's right. I remember now. Yeah. So Velia and her entourage, they got clipping issues. They got stuck in a river. I remember now. They were stuck in a river. So I was running towards that river to go meet up with them. That makes sense. So that's why Red Mountain was where it was. In that little tiny thumbnail, I just assumed I was running down towards Whiterun. But no, I'm heading in the opposite direction, so I'm going southeast. South by southeast. Or east by southeast. Anyway. I'm debating when I should touch down on the ground. Probably don't want to be doing this over a bridge. I'm just asking for my game to crash. I thought for sure Velia and her compadres would come kill the spider so I don't have to. But they're not showing up. No one's coming to my rescue. Oh, faceplant. Isn't there like a goat or a wandering magician, somebody who will take note that I'm getting my ass handed to me and do something about it? A fight. So, okay, the Imperials save the day. What did I do? Did I take skooma? I drank something I shouldn't have. Yeah, I guess it'll wear off. A mental note, try not to save a game when you have this skooma vision going on. Because then when you load the game, it confuses the hell out of the computer. It doesn't know what kind of vision you're supposed to have. It's best to save a game when your skooma has worn off. Okay, there we go. No more skooma effect. Okay, I was wondering where this road led to, and I don't want to go to this place. I want to go somewhere else. The arrows were pointing somewhere, so looks like Velia and somebody else are standing down in the water somewhere. And I was counting on the map markers, which I ran out of, so the map markers for Vilya aren't even showing up. I see them on the map, but I just don't see them above their head. So Aella doesn't have a map marker. Vilya doesn't have a map marker. So I thought I'd move them to me if they can't possibly get from where they are to where I'm at. We're missing somebody else. Somebody else, I thought they were inside the bridge. But no, they were standing there too. They're just...
Make it quick. Take a look.
They have such a low priority, they don't get a map marker. I'm just glad that my companion stayed here instead of getting lost forever. Like in the old days, I used to lose Janessa and Lydia because of clipping. They'd get stuck in rocks behind a waterfall somewhere, and I would never find them.
All right. You
need something? Safe travel.
And then somebody posted on the internet, if you wait like 30 days, then Lydia will be back at Bree's home. So I tried that little trick. I just went somewhere and I waited for that long. Just kept hitting the wait button. And sure enough, Lydia was at the house. Whatever rock she got stuck on or fell behind, she eventually spawned away from it back at the house. But since then, I know a few console commands so I can get companions to catch up with me. So according to the map, Luna is behind us. But I don't see her marker floating anywhere. Meanwhile, something died and slid down this hill. I wanted to see where it went, but... She doesn't show up when I do the red shout that exposes anyone living in the game. I thought, well, maybe she's dead. You know, the map marker is just pointing to where her body is, so I'm going around looking for a dead body that sank to the bottom of the river. Because in my game, dead bodies are told to sink and not float. But I don't see any dead bodies here anywhere. Nothing's trapped under the waterfall. Nothing's clipping over here that's half dry, half wet. Like their legs are hanging in the river kind of a thing, but their arms and legs, or their arms and head, are perfectly dry. So then I thought, well, maybe they fell through the ground and they're trying to get back up to where I'm at, but they don't know how to do that because they fell through the ground mesh and now they're on the texture of the map. That's basically what we're staring at. When you move the camera straight up And you look down, the terrain begins to look like the map. Anyway, she didn't fall through the ground and she's not laying unconscious anywhere down here. So, and I didn't know at this time that I've run out of map markers to use. So Sky UI is just not going to do it. It's weird. Usually someone's home. No, watch. I'll open the door and they're all gonna be in there.